Good afternoon, and thank you all for being here this day as we celebrate the life of Laura Ann Madsen together this day. When we were baptized in Christ Jesus, we were baptized into his death. So we were buried therefore with him by baptism into death, so that as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you today our sister Laura. We thank you for giving her to us to know and to love as a companion in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Illumine our lives so we may see in death the gate to eternal life, that we may continue our course on earth in confidence until by your call we are reunited with those who have gone before us through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. A reading from Mary Fry. Do not stand at my grave and weep. I am not there. I do not sleep. I am a thousand winds that blow. I am the diamond that glints on the snow. I am the sunlight on ripened grain. I am the gentle autumn's rain. When you awaken in the morning's hush, I am the swift uplifting rush, O quiet bird's encircled flight. I am the soft stars that shine at night. Do not stand at my grave and cry. I am not there. I did not die. A reading from Ecclesiastes, the third chapter, beginning at verse 1. To everything there is a season, and a time to every purpose under the heavens, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to get and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to rend and a time to sow, a time to keep silence and a time to speak, a time to move, a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. Now let us share in the 23rd Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, and my cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
As the good knows.
Grace and peace to you from God our Father and our loving Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Amen. There is a season and a time for everything. That is the text the family has chosen to share this day, that reading from Ecclesiastes. And the more I have spent time in this text, the more I realize just how appropriate it is for this particular day. Because at first I was thinking, is there really a time to be grieving the loss of a child and a loved one? And that is hard to wrestle with, it is hard to come to terms with, but I also believe there's so much celebration that is happening in the midst of this. And the more I delved into it and the more that I played with this text, I realized there are musical undertones that are happening within this text, that are happening within this family, that are happening within this celebration. You see, music seems to run a bit here in the Madsen family, and I don't know if it's a genetic thing. I'm not sure where it all necessarily stems from, but it's there and it's alive and it's well. You see, as we think about time, it's an interesting dynamic. You see, I've been told that time can fly or time can stand still. Or according to Tracy Lawrence, time just marches on. Or maybe if you go back to the words of Styx in their song, I just got too much time on my hands. But the one who I think really captured it for this day goes back a few years when Jim Croce said, if I could save time in a bottle. And what he said is that if I could save time in a bottle, the first thing that I'd like to do is to save every day till eternity passes away, just to spend them with you. If I could make days last forever, if words could make wishes come true, I'd save every day like a treasure, and then again, I would spend them with you. Time is precious. And there's times we want to just hold on to that. We want to savor that. But there is so much truth in the saying that time does march on. We cannot just stay in one place, but we continue to move on. But how do we live into that time? I think that is what we are here to do today. We're here to understand that Laura's life was precious. The time that she did have with us, as short as it really was, just shy of 32 years, was still rich time given. It was time filled with goodness. It was time filled with challenges. It was time filled with enrichment. It was precious time. And what is it we do with precious time? Because none of us is guaranteed any length of days. The time that we have, that we have been given, is now. And how do we live in the now? And I've heard it said that living in the now, maybe the way we should embrace precious time is that each and every day we're to do three things. And I believe these words came from Jim Valvano at one point in his career where he said there's three things we need to do. And the first thing we need to do is learn something every day. Learn something. Grow ourselves. Stretch ourselves. And I believe that is something that Laura had done throughout her life, just continued to expand herself in many and varied ways, whether it was taking classes at school in different times, whether it was teaching herself, if you had a chance to ever hear, but the ukulele as a part of her life that is growing, it just enriched, and it's something new. Do we realize that the time we have is so precious that we need to continue to learn something, to grow ourselves, not just for the betterment of self, but for the betterment of those around us. Each and every day, continue to grow. Continue to live. Because today is the day that has been given us. Today is a precious day. And we should also laugh every day. Find the joy in life. find something. We can't take ourselves too seriously all the time. If we do that, there is no joy. But where do we look for joy? Where do we find joy? And maybe more importantly, where do we share joy each and every day? Laugh. You know how good it feels when you get that deep down belly laugh? You get that one where you can't stop laughing and tears start coming down your eyes because you can't hardly catch your breath because you just have a full release of emotion. Embrace the fullness of the here and the now. I know laughter is not something we have to hold back. I truly believe God has the greatest sense of humor of all. Believe me. My pastor flat out said at my ordination, I can't believe you are sitting here being ordained into the church. God has a great sense of humor. I know this is true, and every that video I watched that you all put together, the pictures you chose of Laura, the smile on her faces, the smile of the people around her. She knew how to embrace the joy of life, even amidst the challenges and the struggles that are real. Laugh every day. And the third thing we should do is cry. Allow ourselves to be open. Allow ourselves to be vulnerable. It's okay to cry. Jesus says in John's gospel, I came that all may have life and have it abundantly. And I've come to learn throughout the years that isn't just that we've come to have all the good stuff, but rather we've had learned to have the fullness of life, both the joy and the sorrow, the ups and the downs. It's okay to cry and to embrace life at its fullest. It's cleansing to cry. And they're not always tears of sorrow. Sometimes they are tears of joy. It's okay, whatever it is, each and every day, if we learn a little, if we laugh as much as possible, and if we cry as necessary, we are embracing the preciousness of time. Time is precious. And time is a gift. I always wonder, what is it we do with gifts? You know, when you come to that time in your life when maybe when gifts are exchanged, you know, gifts aren't something we, you know, true gifts are not ones we ask for, but they're ones that are offered to us because somebody has a giving spirit, has a giving heart. And sometimes they come in really pretty wrapped boxes or bags and ribbons. And, you know, you almost hate to tear into them because they're so beautiful just the way they are. Unless you were my kids and the paper's just all gone and it's shredded and it's all a piece. They want to get inside that gift right away. But I think that's the point. Are we willing to dive into the gift that is time, that is life? And what do we do with it? What do you do with a gift? Do you take it and do you use it? Do you share it, or do you stick it up on a shelf in a closet somewhere and just put it away? I think Laura would say she took the gift of time and life and she maximized it. And when I say that, what you're doing, I think the greatest gift that maybe what she did with her gift of time was to give it back to the world, and the greatest gift she gave back is you make the world a better place because you were a part of it. What greater gift is there than that? To know that you've touched enough lives. I always say if you've touched and changed one life, you've made a huge difference. I know for a fact, Laura touched many more lives than just one. You know, visiting with Paul earlier, he just reiterated something that I was well aware of, but it's always good to be reminded of. When this day came, so how do we share this news? How do we share the news that saddens our hearts, but also the news that we're going to continue to celebrate this life that has been shared with us. So in today's modern technology, of course, we're going to use Facebook. We didn't go with Twitter and any of that other stuff. It's going to take us a while, maybe. That's a different generation. But at least we use Facebook, you know, and I felt pretty good about that. We made these announcements that we're going to have this day. I know we made a post through our church, and Paul made a post on his own, and I think between the two, I'm guessing we probably went somewhere over 1,000 comment hits on those. I know we were over 500, and I think yours was as well. You don't get over 500 comments, likes, loves, hearts, whatever it might be, if you didn't touch lives and make the world a better place for you being a part of it. Laura understood life is a gift. not something to be tucked away in a bottle and held and stored, but a gift to be unwrapped, to be torn into, and to be shared for the sake of the world, for the sake of those whom she loved, who she gave herself to. You see, life isn't always perfect and rosy and easy either, and we'd be fooling ourselves if we said that it was. Laura had her share of challenges throughout her life, physically, emotionally, as we all do. But I would say one of the greatest achievements, I guess, if you will, one of the greatest things I can say is she never gave up. She continued moving forward until she would conquer those things that would try to hold her back, because she was determined to live and to share and to make this world a better place, because she was part of it. And finally, I would have to add that time is full of possibilities. I think that is the one thing that we need to hold on to, because where there are possibilities, there is hope. And Scripture tells us that hope never disappoints. You see, Laura's time with us has passed. Her time on this earth has gone. But with that passing and with that leaving, so has her struggle. And her pain is gone. She is in a place now full of brand new possibilities. A place where there is healing, a place where there is glory, a place in the radiance of God's presence for eternity. It is the possibility of life that does not end, but a life that continues on in the presence of God. A life of wholeness, a life of wonder, a place where there is peace, a place where there is wholeness, a place where the lion and the lamb lay together and all is well with our souls. And we know this to be true. That is why each year that we celebrate that empty tomb on Easter morning, where Jesus had been laid 3 days earlier, God says death will not have the final word. Rather, he raised his son, he made that tomb empty, and he said, life will overcome death. My love will overcome anything for the sake of my children. And that is who Laura knew that she was. You see, her motto that you will hear again later, and maybe you've seen it, maybe you already know it: more than this body, more than this mind. She knew she was so much more. She knew she was a child of her Heavenly Father. And that even on her last day, as Kevin shared, as she walked out of her apartment towards the rescue squad, there was no fear. Because she knew she was going home to a place where all things are possible and love and grace abound, in the presence of our loving and living God. And it's in Jesus' name that we give thanks for that this day. Amen.
Sweet the sound of sin.
As I conclude each following prayer petition with God of mercy, I ask that you would respond with, "Hear our prayer." Let us pray. Almighty God, in holy baptism, you have knit your chosen people together into one communion of saints in the body of Christ. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to share the new life in Christ. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Give courage and faith to all who mourn, and a sure and certain hope in your loving care, that casting all their sorrow on you, they may have strength for the days ahead. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Grant to us who are still in our pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith, that where this world groans in grief and pain, your Holy Spirit may lead us to bear witness to your light and life. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Help us in the midst of things we cannot understand to believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to everlasting life. God of mercy, hear our prayer. God of all grace, we give you thanks, because by his death our Savior, Jesus Christ, destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Make us certain that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, shall be able to separate us from your love, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Laura Ann Madsen of Omaha, Nebraska, was born on August 26, 1988, and passed away in Omaha at age 31 on August 9, 2020. She left behind many loving family and friends. Immediately upon her birth, she needed heart procedures as well as major heart surgery at age 5 months. She was baptized at Lord of Love Lutheran Church and was a member of Rejoice Lutheran Church in Omaha, where she participated in youth group activities, including work camp and bell choir for a short time. Laura was a bit of a performer, always quick with a joke, a smile, or a funny story. She graduated from Millard West High School, where she enjoyed playing cello with Mrs. Ritchie in orchestra and was also in choir and drama and forensic activities. She enjoyed traveling to New York City with the choir in her sophomore year and enjoyed being part of the chorus in Millard West's production of Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat. Laura briefly attended Iowa Western Community College and was a lifelong learner, taking numerous classes at Metropolitan Community College over the years. She entered the workforce and worked in teleservices, retail, and daycare before settling into a comfortable vibe at Starbucks Coffee. She worked there for many years and loved the hubbub of activity and chatting it up with the regulars at her shops. In 2014, she connected with her soulmate, Kevin Austin, and the two were inseparable. They enjoyed art and music festivals and getting together with a wide variety of friends. One highlight was a trip they took to Colorado, where they had front row seats at Red Rocks Amphitheater for an amazing outdoor concert looking over Denver from a nearby mountainside. Laura loved the mountains and also enjoyed several Jess and family reunions, which were held in the Estes Park area. In 2016, her heart needed repair again. This led to an amazing 23-hour-long reconstructive heart surgery led by Dr. Jimmy Hamill and his team from Children's Hospital and UNMC. Following the surgery, she was in ICU on a ventilator for 2 months. This led to lung complications, which required her to be on oxygen tank support 24/7 for the next 4 years. After her ICU stay, she spent 3 months at Madonna Rehab Hospital in Lincoln, Nebraska, in order to rebuild her body. Her recovery was aided by daily visits from Kevin. Not surprisingly, Laura made several friends with other long-term Madonna patients as well as employees there. We always laughed at one of her ventilator devices, which she wore, which had regular audio beeps that sounded like the 1970 hit song, "In the Summertime When the Weather is Fine." Odd, yes, but a family legacy. While her constant tether to oxygen might be a burden, Laura's zeal for life still showed through. She was almost always a ray of light for others and prided herself as helping others to discover their healing. All who knew her and her story were impressed with Laura's big picture view of the universe, which is summarized on her Facebook page motto as, "More than this body, more than this mind." To work on her goal to inspire others, she joined the public speaking training organization called Toastmasters. There, she'd worked on her public speaking skills and earned some accolades with the group. Her focus was to help others deal with their disabilities and healing. She wanted her story to inspire others. Kevin said that when Laura descended down the apartment steps toward the rescue squad on Sunday, that she had no fear about what lied ahead. Laura had a deep sense of spirituality and the universe, and she always appreciated and was grateful for Kevin's dedication and his years of loving support. Laura is survived by her grandparents, Verlin and Helga Hansen, her parents, Lisa and Paul Madsen, her younger brothers, Dane and Jake Madsen. Aunts and uncles include Mary Hendrickson and Alan Hansen, Dwayne and Shirley Hansen, Phil and Diane Madsen, Barb Madsen and Dave Cry, loving first cousins, Marin, Christy, Jeremy, Allie, John, and their spouses. She was preceded in death by her grandparents, Lester and Elaine Madsen, and Coral Barnish Madsen, her paternal grandmother. Memorial donations in Laura's name may be directed to Carol Joy Hollenkamp or the American Lung Association, both entities which had an incredible place in her life and her family's life. At this time, let us commend Laura to the mercy of God, our Maker and our Redeemer. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant, Laura. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, and a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. Woo!
Butter's on the sky, burning in your eyes. You look at me, babe, I wanna catch on fire. It's buried in my soul, like California gold. You found the light in me that I couldn't find. So when I'm all choked up but I can't find the words, every time we say goodbye, baby, it hurts. When the sun goes down and the band won't play, I'll always remember us this way. Lovers in the night, though it's trying to ride. We don't know how to rhyme, but damn, we try. But all I really know, you're where I wanna go. The part of me that you will never die. So when I'm all choked up and I can't find the words, every time we say goodbye, baby, it hurts. When the sun goes down and the band won't play, I'll always remember us this way. Oh yeah, I don't wanna be just a memory, baby. The whole world fades, I'll always remember us this way.
Does conclude our service for this day, so let us go forth in peace in the name of Christ. Amen.